Now if a trapezium is in this shape, then let us find the area of the trapezium once again. Then let us check whether we get the same formula or not. Now the trapezium is ABCD in which AB is parallel to DC. Then draw two perpendiculars from A and from B. So from A the perpendicular line. So that is AE. And from B, the perpendicular line is BF. The sides of the trapezium are AB is A units and DC B units. So by drawing these two perpendicular lines, the trapezium is divided into three parts. So the first part is a right triangle. And the second part is a rectangle, and the third part is also a right triangle. So this is the first part, second part, and this is the third part. Now in the first part, let the base of the triangle DE is C, and in the third part, let the base of this right triangle be D units. And in the second part, EF, so that is same as AB. So your AB is A units, so you can take EF also A units. Now to find the area of this trapezium, we should find the area of each part, then we should add these three parts. So here we can write that area of trapezium ABCD. Equals to area of triangle AED plus area of rectangle ABFE plus area of triangle BFC. So your area of triangle AED is half into base into height, half BH, plus area of rectangle is length into breadth, so L into B, plus area of triangle BFC is half into base into height. So half BH. Now area of the triangle AED, half into base means C, so we can write into C into height of this perpendiculars, let it be H. So the both perpendiculars are same as H units. Plus length of the rectangle is A and breadth is H. So we can write A into H plus half into, so base of this triangle BFC is FC, so that is D. Height of this triangle is same as H. Now this equals to half CH, and I am writing half DH as the second term, plus half DH plus A into H can be written as 1 by 2 into 2 into AH. So here also we can cancel 2 and 2, then we get again the same as AH. So in all these three terms, half H is common, 1 by 2 H is common. So if you take 1 by 2 H common, then we get 1 by 2 H of here C plus D plus 2A. Now this equals to 1 by 2 H half C plus D plus 2A can be written as A plus A. So this equals to 1 by 2 into H into here C plus D plus A. C plus D plus A. So C plus A plus D is same as B. So you can write here B in place of C plus D plus A plus A. Now this equals to half into H into B plus A can be written as A plus B. So therefore area of trapezium equals to half into H into A plus B square units. So here also we have got the same formula as we proved just before. So if the land is in the shape of a trapezium, then we can find its area by considering the perpendicular distance between the two parallel sides and the lengths of the two parallel sides. Let us find the area of the following trapezium. So this is a trapezium in which the lengths of the parallel sides are 5 cm and 10 cm and the perpendicular distance between the parallel sides is given as 6 cm. So here the lengths of the parallel sides A equals to 5 cm and B equals to 10 cm. And the distance between the parallel sides, so that is given as 6 cm, means H equal to 6 cm. So we know that area of trapezium formula A equals to half into H into A plus B, then we get A equals to half into, so distance between the parallel sides is 6 cm, 6 into A plus B. So A value is 5 plus B value is 10. So here we can cancel 2 ones are and 2 threes are 6. So 1 threes are 3 into 5 plus 10 is 15. So this equals to 15 threes are 45 centimeter square. So the area of the trapezium is 45 centimeter square. If a field is in the shape of a quadrilateral, then how to find the area of the field? Means how to find the area of the quadrilateral? So far you have no formula to find the area of quadrilateral. Now let us derive a formula to find the area of the quadrilateral. Now consider a quadrilateral ABCD. Now draw any diagonal like AC. So this diagonal AC divides the quadrilateral into two triangles. So that quadrilateral is split into two triangles. So this triangulation method helps us to find the area of regular polygons. Now let the length of this diagonal AC be D units. So your AC equals to D, and draw the perpendiculars from the opposite vertices to the diagonal AC. So from the vertex B, so this perpendicular BE, so let it be H1, BE equals to H1, and from the vertex D, there is another perpendicular, so that is DF. Here DF is perpendicular to AC, so let DF be H2. Here BE and DF are the perpendiculars drawn from the opposite vertices to the diagonal AC. Now area of the quadrilateral ABCD equals to, so area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ADC. Area of triangle ABC plus area of triangle ADC. So this diagonal AC divides the quadrilateral into two triangles. Those two triangles are ABC and ADC. So by adding the areas of these two triangles, then we get the area of quadrilateral ABCD. Then what is the area of triangle ABC formula? So this equals to half into base into height. So then what is the base of triangle ABC? So if AC is the base, then corresponding altitude BF is the height. So we can write that half into base AC into corresponding altitude BE plus area of triangle ADC. So area of triangle ADC equals to half into base. So base is the same AC into corresponding altitude or corresponding height is DF. So this equals to half into, so AC is denoted by D, small d, into, so B is the altitude denoted by H1 plus half into, so diagonal AC denoted by D into DF is H2. Now this equals to, if you take half D common from these two terms, so half D is common, then we get here H1 plus here H2. So this is the formula to find the area of a quadrilateral. Therefore, area of quadrilateral A equals to half into D into H1 plus H2. Here D denotes the length of the diagonal and H1 and H2 are the perpendiculars or altitudes drawn from the opposite vertices to the diagonal of the quadrilateral. So using this formula you can find the area of any field which is in the shape of a general quadrilateral. Now let us find the area of the quadrilateral PQRS. Now in the quadrilateral PQRS, here Q is the diagonal. So this diagonal divides the quadrilateral into two triangles as QRS and QPS. Here the length of the diagonal QS is given by 5.5 centimeters. So your D value, length of the diagonal, D value is 5.5 centimeters. Then the perpendiculars drawn from the opposite vertices to the diagonal. So these two are perpendiculars or altitudes drawn from the opposite vertices R and P to the diagonal QS. So these altitudes are H1 equals to 2.5 centimeters and H2 equals to 1.5 centimeters. So we know that area of quadrilateral formula. A equals to half into D into H1 plus H2. Now let us substitute the given values in this formula. So then A equals to half into, so what is D value here? D value is given by 5.5 centimeters. So half into 5.5 into H1 value. H1 is 2.5 plus H2 value is 1.5. This equals to half into 5.5 into 2.5 plus 1.5 is 4 centimeters. So we can cancel 2 1s are 2, 2 2s are 4. So this equals to 1 2s are 2, then we get 5.5 into 2. So this equals to 2 5s are 10 and 2 5s are 10 plus 1, 11. So this is 11.0. So this equals to 11 centimeter square. So this is the area of the quadrilateral PQRS. So if you know the length of the diagonal and the length of the altitudes drawn from the opposite vertices to the diagonal, then we can find the area of a quadrilateral. Now let us find the area of some special quadrilaterals like rhombus. Now if there is a field in the shape of a rhombus, then how to find its area? But so far we don't know any formula to find the area of a rhombus. Now we will find, means we will obtain the formula to find the area of a rhombus. So a rhombus means in which all the sides are equal. So here AB equals to BC equals to CD equals to DA, and the two diagonals perpendicular bisect of each other, means the two diagonals are perpendicular to each other. So there is a right angle at the point of intersection of these two diagonals, and They also bisect each other, means AO equals to OC and BO equals to OD. So your BO, OD are equal, and AO and OC are also equal. And let us denote the two diagonals AC as D1 and BD as D2. So here also we use the triangulation method to find the area of the rhombus ABCD. Means triangulation method means you will draw a diagonal or two diagonals which divide the rhombus or quadrilateral into two triangles. Here you will find the area of triangle ABD and the area of triangle BCD. Then we will add these two, then we will get the area of the rhombus ABCD. So here we can write that area of rhombus ABCD equals to area of triangle ABD plus area of triangle BCD. So you know the area of the triangle formula, half into base into height. So we can write that half into, so what is the base of the triangle ABD? So that is BD into height is AO plus half in area of the triangle BCD, again half into base into height. So your half into base of the triangle BCD is same as BD into height of the triangle BCD. So what is the height of the triangle BCD? So that is OC. Now this equals to half into BD is common in these two terms. Half BD is common. If you take half into BD common, then we get AO plus OC. This equals to half into BD into. So what is AO plus OC? AO plus OC is same as AC. So we can write that AC in place of AO plus OC. So this equals to half into, then what is BD? The length of the diagonal BD is denoted by D2 into the length of the diagonal AC is denoted by D1. So this equals to half D1 D2 square units. So D2 into D1 is same as D1 D2. So therefore we can write that area of rhombus A equals to half D1 D2. Means if you know the lengths of the diagonals of a rhombus, then we can find its area. Now let us find the area of a rhombus. Find the area of a rhombus whose diagonals are of lengths 10 cm and 8 cm. So here the lengths of the diagonals are given. So the length of the first diagonal D1 is given that 10 cm, and the length of the second diagonal D2 is given as 8 cm. Then the area of rhombus A equals to half D1 D2 square units. So if you substitute D1 D2 values in this formula, then we get A equals to half into D1 value is 10 cm, which is the length of the first diagonal, and D2 value is 8 cm, which is the length of the second diagonal. So this equals to 2 1s are 2, 2 5s are 10, so 1 5s are 5 into 8. So this equals to 40 cm square, so which is the area of the rhombus.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.